which are not true.
Ambavyo si kweli.
And now,
na sasa,
if you worship something wrong,
ukiabudu kitu ambacho ni makosa,
you become a false worshiper.
Unakuwa mwabuduo wa muongo. Unanipata?
Yes.
So you must understand what you are worshiping. So lazima uelewe kile ambacho unaabudu.
If you just smile for the things because of people are bowing for things,
yeah, ukisujudia tu vitu kwa sababu watu wanasujudia,
you will find yourself a false worshiper.
Utajipata ya kwamba wewe ni mwabuduo wa uongo.
So we must worship what we know.
So lazima tuabudu kile ambacho tunajua.
God is the way.
Sasa Mungu
God is the truth.
Na Mungu ni kweli.
And is the life.
Na Mungu ni uzima.
So if you come to him,
kwa hivyo ukija kwake,
you must know who he is.
Lazima ujue yeye ni nani.
He is the light.
Yeye ni neno.
He is the life.
Yeye ni uzima.
He is the truth.
Yeye ni
kweli. He is the spirit.
Yeye ni roho.
So before you worship him,
so kwa kabla umwabudu,
get in the spirit of God.
Lazima uingie katika roho wa Mungu.
And now get away from the things which are not true.
Na utoke yaani kujiepusha na vitu ambavyo si vya kweli.
Then you worship that God.
Hivyo utamwabudu.
He is a true God.
Ambaye ni Mungu wa kweli.
Blessed be the name of the Lord.
Amen.
So how do you worship him?
Yeah, unamwabudu aje sasa.
By the right teachings.
Kwa mafundisho mema.
By the right doctrines.
Kwa
mafundisho yaliyo sawa.
Yaliyo sawa.
By the right baptisms.
Kwa ubatizo ambao ni kweli.
Unanipata?
Amen.
And there is a poet who has written a statement. There is a poet or a writer.
Yeah, kuna mwandishi aliandika.
I'm just closing because I want to go to the next stage. Bwana Mungu abariki sana.
Amen.
Now,
sasa,
let me share with you something Spotify cross.
Akionyesha kitu kidogo pika plus.
There are many things on earth.
Kuna vitu vingi sana duniani.
The Bible says,
kama tu vile Biblia inasema,
you worship in vain.
Unaabudu
kwa bure.
Kwa bure.
Yes, you are worshiping.
Ndio unaabudu.
Worshiping in vain.
Lakini unaabudu bure.
There are many things on earth.
Kuna vitu vingi katika dunia
that people are worshiping.
Ambavyo watu wanaabudu.
But in their hearts,
lakini katika mioyo yao,
they are rejoicing truly they are worshiping.
Ndio wanafurahia kwamba wanaabudu kweli.
But at the end of the worship,
lakini katika mwisho wa ibada,
their worship is in vain.
Ibada yao inakuwa bure.
Amen.
Amen.
There are things you can do.
Kuna vitu unaweza fanya.
At the end of the day,
yeah, mwisho wa siku,
you can never find God in it.
Huwezi pata Mungu ndani.
And many things are being done throughout the world.
Na vitu vingi vinafanyika katika ulimwengu mzima.
Wrong things,
vitu ambakosa.
And people are worshiping.
Na watu wanaabudu.
And in their hearts,
na katika mioyo yao,
they are convicted.
Wanajua
wanaabudu the true God.
Kwamba wanaabudu Mungu.
But the Bible says,
lakini Biblia inasema,
in vain,
lakini bure.
Worship me. Because you never worshiped God.
Yes.
And you never knew whom you are worshiping.
Would you are you about
now? Yes, you came to worship.
Yes, yes, ndio ulikuja kuabudu.
But you bowed to something which is false.
Lakini kusujudia kitu ambacho kilikuwa ni uongo.
But in your heart,
lakini katika
moyo wako,
ulinyenyekea.
You are doing it with all your heart.
Unafanya na moyo wako
wote. Something you are doing is wrong.
Lakini kila unafanya ni makosa.
Bwana bariki sana.
Amen.
And that's the things the Bible is saying. It makes you a false worshiper. Yes, you are worshiping, but you are a false worshiper. But you worshiper. Now, it's just like, now, let me give you this example. The Bible says there is one faith, which is the true faith. There is one baptism, which is the true baptism. There is the way of God, and there is the way of man. But today, men have forsaken the true way of God, and they have taken man's way. Yes, it's a way. But where is it leading people? Like we say,
kama tu vile tumesema,
in the Bible,
katika Biblia,
we have one baptism.
Kuna,
we have one doctrine.
Kuna, fundisho moja.
We have one spirit.
Kuna roho moja.
But today,
lakini leo
there are almost thousands and thousands of baptisms.
Leo hii kuna aina nyingi sana ya.
There are thousands of faiths.
Kuna maelfu ya imani.
Now,
na sasa,
how can you know that this is the true faith?
Tunajuaje ya kwamba hii ni imani ya kweli?
And one man said,
na mtu mmoja akasema,
when a lie stays so long,
yani mstari ukikaa
uongo,
uongo ya ukikaa muda mrefu,
mambo ambayo si sawa,
yes,
watu wakiyazoea na ikae miongoni mwao muda mrefu,
yes,
wanaanza kufikiria ni kweli, na kumbe ni makosa. So you can live in a lie,
yeah, kwa hivyo unaweza ishi katika,
and worship God in a lie,
na uabudu Mungu katika
Just like the Bible says, one baptism. But how many baptisms do we have in the
world?
There are so many.
Amen.
But which one is the correct? Which one will God accept?
That's
I'm talking about. So you can believe something for a long time. Na ikawa kwamba kila mtu ameikubali.
Yes.
Na kumbe ni makosa.
Amen.
Amen.
Kweli.
Kama vile wa kama vile the 400 prophets of Baal.
Wale manabii wa Baal.
You could never believe
what a hungaamini
all were wrong.
Na kwamba walikuwa makosa.
No one had a conviction to know they were wrong.
Hakuna mtu alikuwa na hukumu ndani mwake.
All of them prophesized.
Wote walitoa unabii.
But at the end of it,
lakini katika mwisho wa huo unabii,
all of them were false.
Unabii wote ulikuwa uongo.
Mnasoma Biblia.
Amen.
400.
400.
And they refused to hear only one man.
Na walikataa kumsikiza mtu mmoja tu.
Who had the true way.
Ambaye alikuwa na njia yake.
And today,
leo hii,
many are falling in many hands.
Wengi wanaanguka katika mikono
mingi. Because of respect of people.
Kwa sababu ya kuheshimu watu.
And they are worshiping things which are wrong.
Na wanaabudu vitu ambavyo ni makosa.
Thinking they are worshiping God.
Wakiamini ya kwamba wanaabudu Mungu.
Yes, you go to church.
Wanaenda kanisani.
You are doing things you think is the Bible.
Unafanya vitu unafikiria.
Lakini at the end,
lakini mwisho wake,
when the true owner of the Bible comes.
Wakati mwenye Biblia anakuja.
Na kupima kwa ratili ya neno lake, anakupata wewe ni mwongo.
Amen.
Because you are not living according to the word. You are not doing the Bible. Yes, you are worshiping. But you become a false worshiper. Just like you take a baptism which is not in the Bible. Just like the Bible says, women should not cut their hair and you cut your hair. So you are denying the true worship. So when you
God,
he will ask you, did you worship to me? No. You cut your hair. True worship has characteristics. There are things which identify them to be the true worshippers. God is happy to receive them. Have accepted the true way.
Amen.
So some cut their hair and they come to worship. They are worshiping in vain.
Some
people check dresses and they come to worship. They
are
worshiping in vain. Because the Bible says, put on apparent clothes that you may keep yourself. So don't come before the Lord when you are naked. You will not accept the worship. God has not accepted such a thing which are contrary to his word. Which are contrary to his word. Because the word is his truth. Neno ndio kweli ya Mungu. Mungu ukipima katika misani ya neno lake. Because God is known by his word. By his word. Mungu anajulikana kwa neno lake. Kwa kuna mambo anafanya ambayo inakutambulisha kwa Mungu wa kweli. Sasa Mungu anatafuta hao watu. Watu gani ambao ni watiifu kwa neno. Ambao wanaweza kuvunjika
watembee kulingana na neno.
Amen.
Ambao wanaweza fanya mambo kulingana na neno lake. Wezi kanisani.
Yes.
Waongo kanisani.
Yes.
Yeah. Are you worshiping really a true God?
Wewe unaabudu Mungu wa kweli?
No.
Na hapana.
You find criminals in the church.
Unapata wahalifu kanisani.
All of them.
Wote.
Wote wa kanisani.
Yes.
And all of them are worshiping.
Na wote wanaabudu.
Some are playing music. But they are liars. They are adulterers. They are fornicators. Some are preaching. But they are adulterers. So what are they doing? Yes, they are worshiping. But true worshippers must understand what they are doing. Don't just fall in traps and think because you are going to church.
No.
So you must be a true worshipper. Worshipping God in truth. Not in false things. You must live right. You must walk as a Christian. Don't profess to be a Christian and you are not. Don't be a Christian. In the day you go to church, in the evening, in the evening, they go say to worship. You say, Lord, you know I went to church.
You know I didn't go to
church. And I'm also telling my brother, if you are going to start with the foundation of God, let me tell you, the blood of Jesus can keep you from every evil. The blood of the Lord is not the blood of animals. It's our blood that saves our life. It's our blood that is powerful beyond. And if you accept that blood, there will be nothing that can harm you. There will be no evil in this house. If we place this house under the blood of Christ, you come with your evil, they will be back to you.
Amen.
If you truly believe Christ, there is no witchcraft that can penetrate a Christian. There is no power of darkness that can penetrate light. Because darkness and light have no fellowship. So if you believe Christ, there will be nothing to harm your life. There is no power. There is no anything. But you are covered by the love of God. So you become a hidden treasure. Wewe ni mtu ambaye umepeanwa
kama ya.
And you are standing there representing Christ.
Yeah, yani umepeanwa kama
kipawa
cha kipekee.
Cha kipekee duniani.
Yes.
Na unaishi maisha ambayo mtu akiangalia atasema kweli huyu mama ni Mkristo.
Amen.
Kweli huyu baba ni Mkristo.
Amen.
Kweli kijana ni Mkristo.
Amen.
Kuna maisha ambayo ina question marks.
Yes.
Question marks.
Yeah,
yani ukitembea ina maswali nyuma.
Yes.
Ukifanya mambo ina maswali nyuma.
Yes.
Majirani wanakuswali.
Yes.
Wafanyakazi wako wanakuswali. Unanipata? Mwajiri wako anakuswali. Huyu mtu ni wa aina gani? So you must be a true person.
Lazima uwe mtu wa kweli.
You must be a true worshipper.
Lazima uwe mwabudu wa kweli.
God is seeking such to worship him today.
Kama huyo wa kumwabudu yeye.
True worshippers.
Mwabudu wa kweli.
So there are many things people are worshiping, but they are false. Don't be a false worshiper. Now that our brother is going to be a worshiper here. Now,
yes.
This house, he is dedicating it for the glory of the Lord. And he will say, mchana saa saba,
inajiweka watu kubwa.
Amen. Ama ni saa nani, sikio? Na nyumba ya? Na watoto wangu. Kwa hivyo Bwana tunasalimisha mikononi mwako.
Amen.
Tukiamini tutakuwa waabudu waaminifu.
Amen.
Kwa neno lako.
Amen.
Wakiweka hii nyumba wakifu kwa Bwana, wakisema Bwana, hebu hii nyumba iwe kwa utukufu wa jina lako.
Amen.
Kitu ambacho tunafanya, wale wataingia, wale watatoka, wapate wema wa Bwana. Wakuje waseme kweli tunawaabudu halisi mahali pale. So we must be true worshippers today. Oh, be a true worshipper in your home. Be a true worshipper in your church. Be a true worshipper in your village. Let everyone see the goodness of the Lord in you. That you are a true worshipper. May the Lord bless you for that.
Amen.
Mnapenda Mungu kwa hiyo?
Amen.
Now, for short minutes, let's now come to dedication. Let us pray. Our loving Father, we thank you, precious Lord. Yes, for your wonderful word. for such good thoughts towards us, Father.
Amen.
We thank you for everyone who came, Lord.
Yes, Lord.
Thank you, Lord, for blessing us in this day.
Amen.
Thank you for blessing my brother.
Amen.
All remembering him as he lives on earth. That, Lord, it was good for you to give him this house, to give him this place, Lord.
Amen.
To give him a wife and the children.
Yeah.
The Lord, together, they may live to see the goodness of the Lord.
Amen.
And to declare what the Lord can do, my Father.
Amen.
Thank you, Father, for the witnesses who came.
Yes.
Thank you for every brother and every sister. Thank you for the fathers, parents.
Yes.
Lord, we appreciate you for the grace.
Amen.
Now, as we come, we pray that you be with us.
Amen.
As we commit this house in your hands,
yes, Lord.
We ask for blessings.
Yes.
That the blood of Jesus wash and cleanse us, Father.
Amen.
That will be vessels of honor.
Amen.
Lord, as we commit ourselves to you,
Amen.
In Jesus' precious name we pray.